guys, Tammy here. I am back with a tutorial video. I am going to show you guys how to make these Hershey Kisses boxes. I made some for Christmas and they were pretty simple because I was putting them in gift boxes, but I wanted to just pop on and show you guys how I made these. The construction paper that I used for this one, I don't feel like it was sturdy enough, so the lid kind of sinks in. But this will hold 10 Hershey Kisses. So for this project, you're going to need a 5 by 8.5 piece of paper, cardstock, preferably one that's a little bit thicker. You're going to need about a 20-inch piece of ribbon, and I used my new We Are Mimic Keepers ribbon cutter. And I guess what it does is it also seals the end, which is cool. I don't have to use a lighter anymore for that. But anyway, so I did my little ends just like I would on here. And on here, I actually used a lighter, and you can tell it's not as straight. And you can tell I used a lighter. So anyway, so you're going to need that ribbon, and that's about 20 inches long. It might be a little less since I did use the ribbon cutter to cut the ends. And you're going to need some other cardstock. And what I'm using is the Paper Studio Vintage Valentine paper pad. And it's 6x6. This is the perfect size to use for these boxes. You're only going to cut off an inch on the top for it to fit on this box. And then I did a little square on the bottom, and I did a square on the top. So I'll show you how to do that. And I love this paper pad. I got it last year. And then I cut I think this is a 1.5-inch scallop circle out of the some leftover paper that I had from last year that I didn't use. And then I did, I think this is a, I want to say it's a one, what is that? It's like 1.25-inch circle, and that's going to go on top. We're going to emboss that, a heart on there, and this heart, and I'll show you how I do that. I'm using Mimi Maidens. This is her, which collection is this? This is her stamp, All About You collection, and I'm using this big heart right here. So that's what we're going to be doing. So you're going to need, whatever stamp you want to put on there. And we are going to need some Versamark watermark stamp pad, and I'm using Nouveau Classic Gold embossing powder, and you're going to need a stamp block. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to get started on here, and I'm going to show you how to make this. So you're going to need your scoreboard, and on your 5-inch side, make sure I got the right one. So on your 5-inch side, you're going to score every inch. Pretty simple. So 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch, and 4 inch. Then you're going to turn it on the 8.5 by 8.5 side, and you're going to score it at 1 and 2, and then you're going to come over and you're going to score it at 7.5. Okay, that's all you need the scoreboard for. So we're going to put the scoreboard away. I'm also going to use this 3M, this is the skinny one. So I'm going to use this 3M foam tape to mount the circle, this little decorated piece here, so that it doesn't have, I don't have to worry about the ribbon. It can move or do whatever I need it to do. So we're going to have that. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to cut our box down, and I'm going to use my Tim Holtz scissors because I like them the best. What you're going to do is you're going to have 4 tabs on the bottom, and this little corner here, we don't need that corner, so we're going to cut that off. If I can see it right up to that first score line. Then we're just going to come over here, and we're going to cut that off to that first score line, just like that, okay? And then on these, what we're going to do is we're going to cut them right down the middle of the score line, as best as you can. Alright, now, on this first one and this third one, we're going to cut at an angle. We're going to miter those corners. Okay, we're going to do that on both sides. And then we're going to cut that little tab in half. This tab's going to fold onto the inside, so we don't really care if that one's long. And it just fits the box better together. When you go to put it together, it's not as bulky on the bottom. So I'm just going to miter those corners. And then I'm going to just cut that one about in half. Just like that. We're going to take a little bit off. Okay, that's all you're going to do to the bottom. Now to the top, this is the piece, the second piece over from the right. When you flip it like this, here's your missing corner, okay? Really important to remember this. This isn't even straight. I need to cut that straight. Sorry about that. So this is going to be the part that folds into the box. So this is the lid part. So we don't need these six squares, and we don't need these two squares. So we're just going to cut those off. So you're going to cut down right to that second score line. And you're going to cut that off. That was kind of crooked, but it's okay. And then we're going to cut this one down to the second score line. And then we're going to come down to that second score line, and we're going to cut all the way up to that third score line. Okay? That is your box. That's all you have to do. It's pretty simple. So, anyway, let me throw my trash away. Alright, now, this part here, this is going to be your lid, so we're just going to fold and burnish all the score lines. Make sure it's straight. Okay. And then each one of these I'm not worried about being straight because they're going to be on the inside. These are all going to fold over. Yeah, this paper is definitely thicker than the paper I used for the other box, so I'm hoping it works out better. Alright, and then you're going to just fold and burnish lightly on the score line here, and all the long ones. And then that's the last one. Alright, so when you put this together, you're going to have to remember this. This piece that we cut the corner away, that's actually going to be on the inside of the box. So when you put your mats on, you want to make sure that you don't mat that one, because nobody's going to see it. You want to mat all of the other four, okay? So, let's see. Yeah, so we're going to mat this one, and this one. So what I did was, I picked out one of the sheets that I liked in the paper collection. Let's see, we'll just kind of browse through here. Ooh, I like that. I think that's really pretty. Alright, that's going to be our paper. And I've already cut out my scallop circle and my little pink circle. And I'm just going to go ahead and use those. Alright, so what you're going to do is you're going to take your paper cutter. Pretty sure I cut off an inch. Let's see. No. Okay, so let's measure this. So the strips are going to be 5 1/4, and you're going to do 7/8. Okay, so 7/8 by 5 1/4 is what we're going to do. So this. The top. Alright, so 5 1/4. And then I'm going to cut each strip at 7/8. So you need 4 of those. And And I try to keep them designed so that the design is kind of flowing through on the box. Keep them in order. Okay. And this is going to help make your box sturdier too. So, and we actually need 5 of these strips because we're going to use, we're going to cut one of them down. We're going to cut 2 little squares down. So you're going to have, this is 7/8. So you're going to cut 1 square at 7/8. There's your top or your bottom, whatever you want to do. And then we need another one at 7/8. Okay. All right, so that's for the top and bottom. Put your cutting board away. We won't need that now. So now we're going to mat all of our pieces, all right? And so for this, you can use glue, you can use an ATG gun, you can use red line tape, whatever you want to do. These are probably going to get thrown away, so I wouldn't get too fancy with them. And we're just going to line that up, making sure we get our borders. Okay. And I'm putting this, when I cut the strips, I made sure I paid attention to the designs so that they flowed together. So I'm just going to do, I'm going to put that one there. So it just, the design flows through to all the pieces and they look uniform like that. Okay, oh, come back. And that's going to be the 4 sides of our box. Okay. All right. And then, so when you fold it up, you're gonna, it's going to look like this. So see how your design just flows all the way around. And then what you want to do is, this is going to be your outside piece on the bottom, because you're going to be folding those 2 in, this one in, and then this one's going to get glued to that one. So we're going to put a square on this one, and at this point, these don't really matter. Whichever one you want to use, it doesn't matter. I'm just going to use my art glitter glue and put this on. And I use the art glitter glue for this so I can make sure that I get it kind of centered on that little piece right there. And then we're going to put this piece on the lid. And again, I did not do this to the ones I made for Christmas because they were going in a gift basket. And I wasn't too concerned about that. So, all right, so on this piece, we're going to glue this piece to the inside of this piece here. So I'm using glue because it gives me more wiggle room to make sure that it's adhered and straight with the other side. So So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay this down. I'm going to fold this over like this. And I'm going to line that up like that. And then I'm going to press it in. And that's going to give me the box. So there's your box. Now on the end, I'm just going to fold those two little half-cut pieces in. Fold the piece that doesn't have a mat like that. I'm going to hold it so that it's uniform. So the box is square. Okay. Fold that over. And I'm just going to make sure that the bottom of my box is square. Just like that. That's the bottom. And then your top is just going to fold in like that. Okay. That's all you do. All right. So now your box is done. And then I tried to do this with the box when this is open, but you're going to want to put tape. And I use the 1/8 inch tape because what we want to do is we're going to, on the back of the box, so this is how the box folds in, like this. So we want the ribbon to wrap around here, here, and here, and tie up here. So I want to put just a little bit. I'm wondering if I should use, I'll use the thicker one that I just bought. I think that'll work. The red line tape. I think I'm going to use. Oh, this is the half inch. I don't want a half inch. Okay, I want the quarter inch. Yep. I used the 1/8 inch, but. Sorry. Okay, that's not good. Why did I do that? Alright, so I used the 1/8 inch on the other one that I made, but I felt like I needed to use a little bit thicker red line tape, so I'm going to use the 1/4 inch. Alright, and this stuff is sticky. So, we're going to, right in the center of the box, we're going to lay, oh my gosh, this stuff is really sticky. We're going to lay that in the center of the box, just like that. Okay, that's on the back. We're going to wrap that around the bottom here. And I'm going to cut it off right there, okay? Because I'm not worried about, I don't want it to stick to the front of the box. I want it to look, you know, like it's just been tied up, like the box has been tied up. So we're going to take that tape off. And then I'm going to kind of center the ribbon. Center, because this is going to tie at the top, so you want more to wrap around the bottom than the top. Alright, so we're going to, or else you'll have to put your bow like right in the middle of the box, like that. We're going to fill it with our Hershey Kisses, and this takes 10, you can actually get 10 Hershey Kisses in here, which is really cool. That's actually a lot. So there, it fits those 10 little Hershey Kisses in there, and then we're going to close the box up, just like that. We're going to take this, and we're going to come up here, we're going to tie our little bow. Maybe I should have cut it at, so don't just have to kind of play with it and get it to where you're comfortable with it. So, yeah, so I'm still playing with how to get this to wrap around the right way, but it's okay. So there's your bow. So now we're going to take our little circle, and I think I'm going to go ahead and glue this because last time it was just easier to do it this way. So I'm going to glue the circle onto the scallop and then center it just like that. So I don't want any bumps in it from the glue. Put my glue away. And then I'm going to take my Versamark embossing powder. And I just got some refill for this pad, so I'm actually excited to get to use it again. So we're going to just ink that up. We're going to put that down. Make sure we get a good amount of ink on that. Sorry, I had my head in the way. Okay, just like that. I'm going to peel it off. Okay. And then I am going to take my gold embossing powder and I'm just going to sprinkle that on there. It's okay if you get a little bit of embossing powder on there. You can just take, I just usually take a brush, a little paintbrush, and I just kind of, I don't usually use that one. I usually use this one. Just brush it away so you don't emboss that. Just like that around your design. And then if you want to, so you don't burn yourself, because this is kind of a small piece. I usually take, which I can't find right now, so I will take these pliers. I'm going to hold this like this. Just like that. I'm going to take my heat gun. And make sure your gun is really, really hot before you try to emboss anything. That's good. And then you're just going to emboss this. Okay. And I kind of move it around in circles so I don't burn the paper. And I do an even embossing. Alright. Let that cool for a minute. So while that's cooling, I'm going to go ahead and cut just enough foam tape that it's going to hold that little circle. So I just cut a piece out, maybe not even half an inch, and then I'm going to cut that in half, just like that, and then I'm going to put it on either side of the ribbon. So the ribbon's actually going to go in the middle, just like that, so I don't have to hold the ribbon down or anything like that. I'm going to put this on the other side, just like that. And see, that ribbon's just going to sit right in there, and it's not going to, you know, look like it's taped down or whatever, which is cool. And then I'm going to remove the tape from the foam tape. Take my little heart, and I'm just going to put that right center, just like that. Okay, and there is your box of Hershey Kisses. So you can add, you know, if you want to add a tag to it, to the ribbon, you can tie a tag through the center of the ribbon. you know, and put your to and from on there. You could put this in a gift basket. You could give it, you know, with a Valentine's Day gift to, or a card to your coworkers or whatever. But these are the two that I made, and I'm going to make more, but I'm definitely going to cut the ribbon, longer and then put more coming from the top up. So anyway, those are the boxes that I'm making right now for Valentine's Day. Thanks for watching my video. You guys, I really super appreciate it. If you could hit that like button, that would be awesome. And if you'd like to subscribe to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. And if you'd like to be notified when I upload more videos, please hit the little bell icon next to the subscribe button, and you'll get an email notification when I do upload a new video. So anyway, thanks again, you guys, for stopping by. I hope you like this tutorial. It's pretty simple. I think these would make awesome gifts for coworkers. There's so many different things that you could do with this. And along with the Hershey Kisses boxes that I made last month for Christmas, you know, you can make those boxes as well for Valentine's Day. And I'll leave a link to that video in the description box below if you haven't seen that one yet. So, and I think there might be one more box of candy. I can't remember. But yeah, that one's definitely, I'll definitely list that one below. And if I can find the other one, I'll list that one as well. So anyway, thanks again for stopping by and watching. I hope you guys have a blessed week, and I will talk to y'all later.